his belly before he went to bed. Today, on the menu, if you haven't seen already, is steak with onions and peppers on the side with a broccoli. I used one pan for it all. Yes, one pan. I did not feel like doing a whole bunch of dishes at all. I will be doing a voiceover for most of this video because my brother was watching YouTube. I hope you guys don't mind the white noise in the background. I have my AC on, even though the temperature is starting to slowly drop outside. My room holds a lot, and I mean a lot, of heat. I also think my plant light contributes to that heat because my plant light is on most of the day. Those of you who don't know, I have plants in my room. And I have to have a plant light on at least every other day because the way my room is facing, I don't get light from either window. It's funny, I have two windows in my room. I barely get any light. So, the plant light comes in handy. I have a bunch of trees in my front yard, so they're blocking the light. So you'd think it would be cooler in my room because the sun's not beaming that much on the roof where my room is, but no, it's very hot. But anyway, right now, I'm just taking apart some fresh garlic. I love garlic. I couldn't be a vampire. I just love garlic so much, I could eat it by itself. So I'm taking a few cloves, and I'm going to mince it. Also, make sure you all have something under your cutting board so it doesn't slide all over the place like how mine was in the beginning. I forgot to put a wet napkin or something under it, so that's why I went and grabbed those little mats you put in the cabinet. It keeps your cutting board in place. And it keeps you safe from getting any cuts. I hope you guys are doing well today. I hope you guys find this somewhat relaxing or somewhat entertaining. I know there will be some background noise. You'll hear whatever he's watching on YouTube. I hope that's okay. For anyone that's new, don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe. Also, let me know what you would like to see from the channel. Now, we are almost at 500 subscribers, so somebody will be getting a custom video uploaded to the channel very soon. Here, I'm just slicing my peppers. I had them in the fridge for a while. I had made Salisbury steak from scratch. And I just wanted to get rid of them before they went bad. We recently brought a new stove. So we have a new microwave, a new stove. Now we have to get a new fridge because the fridge does not keep vegetables and fruit fresh. As long as they should last. So, that's another reason why I'm cutting them. Because I could have kept them a little longer, but my fridge is not the best. It's very old. It came with the house while we brought the house. So we just never went and brought a new fridge. And I'm not going to deal, but they're so damn expensive. Oh my god. I did find a Samsung fridge for like $1,100 that I'm interested in. There's also one for $1,600. It has like a water pitcher inside, along instead of it being on the outside, like where you put the cup to get ice or water. It's in the inside of the fridge, and there's also a pitcher that comes with it. And then when you open the deep freezer at the bottom, they have a little scoop for you so you can put ice. But that also, that's probably going to be the one that I get. Sticky. Tops off the peppers and cleaning out the guts. Do not cook the seeds or the guts. It doesn't like it. I don't know why, but doing a voiceover, it's so much harder than I thought it was. My throat is already like dry. So, I'm gonna finish cutting up the peppers. And I'm gonna take a little break and let you guys just watch.
Right after the living room.
With
his money.
Stop just seasoning.
I would hate. him home. Like, I don't even know.
My next cooking video will be much better. It'll be quieter. Yeah.
microphone we're on? So Barry got a handful of people in.
She did it to herself. I'll be damned. Mm-hmm. I'd have been like, motherfucker, you could kiss my ass.
Hi, everybody. This is Ashley Dyke, and I am back with another old Hollywood scandal video. And honey, I am so glad y'all are here, honey. This is a juicy one. This is a juicy one. I got to thank Rachel for sending me this story. Thank you, girl. And another person I need to thank is Steve Williams. Thank you so much for getting me a gift off of my Amazon wish list.
I'm gonna need her to get a mic.
If you guys wanna buy me a gift from the Amazon wish list, the link is in the description. And honey, I had to rush through all of that because without further ado, we are about to get to this messy marriage between Nova and Leah Faith. Let's get to it. Y'all know my disclaimer. I do not know what's true or false. I just find gossip and tea from online.
You're entertaining the line. Word of mouth,
yeah, she needs to get a microphone. Very expensive now.
His mother's name was Kay Francis Spinks, and his father's name was Leon Spinks Sr. Now, on top of Leon, the Spinks has several children, and none of these children had a good childhood.
Child of
Leon's daddy was mostly absent, and then when he
I think he's ready to start eating meat with him.
And allegedly, when Leon and his siblings looked to their mother,
I'm getting tired of the drugs.
Francis used to be ripping and
running
the streets, baby, doing all kind of drugs.
I bought some real food tomorrow.
So because Leon had this type of childhood,
or I give James the money he could buy him.
The fresh and go stuff. And the streets himself, getting into all type of trouble. And I would delve deeper into some of the mistakes that Leon made.
You want some water? You want some water?
It's not about his life alone. It's about him and his wife. So I'm not going to move along because we got a lot of scandal to cover. Matter of fact, I'm going to go ahead and jump to the year 1974. Because actually joined the military and he was stationed in Texas. Now, most of the time, the military takes people and straightens them right on out. Baby Leon was the exception. That boy stayed in Army jail, stayed in trouble with the MPs and everything. The only thing good that was happening for Leon at this time is that he was able to make new friends. And one of those friends was a guy by the name of JC, who was from Iowa. Well, gossip claims one day JC and Leon are just sitting in their room in the barracks, and JC is on the phone with his girlfriend from back home. And so while he is talking, Leon tells JC, hey, JC, they asked your girl if she knew any single girls. Somebody for me. And it just so happened she did know somebody. A cousin of hers, a girl by the name of Nova Sage. So Leon gets Nova's number, and Nova starts to tell him about herself. She tells him that she's 20 years old. She says she's a single mother to a young baby boy. She tells him that she got her own apartment, her own car, she got a good job.
Oh, what's
the
car?
I can't
wait to get these things to close or quit.
This is the woman for me. Now, while Leon and Nova is in this long distance relationship, Leon.
I cut them, they just grow back up.
When Leon and Nova actually meet, Leon was so in love and so impressed with Nova that he immediately wanted to take her to go and meet his mother back in St. Louis. And this right here is where the first sign of trouble started. So, gossip claims Leon and Nova fly out to children's Bible study in her front room. So when Leon and Nova walk through the front door, Kay Francis just kind of shoos them away to the back room. So Leon and Nova go to the back room, and one of Leon's little brothers is back there. And so Nova is kind of smiling and cheesing.
Make me over.
When suddenly she hears,
make me know.
You get your tail from my back. And so Nova is caught off guard, and Leon is absolutely embarrassed. And then he turns to Nova and starts apologizing and kind of just explaining, you know, sometimes my mama do too much. And so Nova is whispering, and she's like, yeah, she do kind of.
And when I'm done,
approaches the hotel room door, and right off the bat she hears a female's voice.